right, John, thank you so much. This is some important information. The FDA approved O pill, the first daily contraceptive pill over the counter. You don't need a prescription. Then came legislation which offers more people access to an option for preventing pregnancy. Dr. David Eisenberg, Chief of Division of Complex Family Planning at WashU and Barnes Jewish Hospital, is here live with details. Good morning to you.
Morning.
So first off, tell me a little bit about O-pill and what people might need to know if they've never been on birth control pills before.
Sure. So O-pill is literally one of the oldest kind of birth control pills that's been around. The active ingredient has been in all birth control since birth control pills became available. It's super safe, it's super effective, and it's really easy for people to take as long as they try to take it around the same time every day, and it can be very effective.
Okay, gotcha. So in the past, you've had to go inside of a doctor's visit and have a well woman exam in order to get prescribed birth control. Tell me a little bit about how this will, you know, possibly change some things without that being a requirement anymore.
So there is a tradition that you'd have to have a checkup to get birth control.
Right.
But the fact of the matter is, to get birth control, you don't need to see a healthcare provider. You can get all kinds of birth control at the pharmacy without a prescription. Things like condoms and spermicides. But this is now the most effective over-the-counter, without a prescription, birth control method that's available. Doesn't protect from sexually transmitted infections,
right?
But it adds to that menu of choices that people have needed forever to plan when and if to have a baby, right? Mm-hmm. And we love the fact that patients have more and more choices. But if this doesn't work for them or some of the other options that are available don't work for them, I would encourage them to seek out a healthcare provider like their own physician or, you know, a federally funded health clinic like ours. We run the Contraceptive Choice Center at WashU and Barnes Jewish Hospital, which ensures that people, regardless of their insurance status, have access to all contraceptive methods.
Okay, so also what happens in these exams are some screenings mm-hmm. sometimes. So what are some instances where people still need to make sure that they come in and see you all in order to get the screenings and make sure everything is okay?
It's an excellent question. So everybody who has a sexual partner, especially under the age of 25, should be screened at least once a year
okay.
for sexually transmitted infections. And for many times, including women, that can be just a urine test. They don't necessarily even have to get undressed in the presence of their healthcare provider.
Okay.
The other thing is that women especially should have a cervical cancer test.
Mm-hmm.
That's a Pap test. Many people think that every time a pelvic exam is done, they're having a Pap test done. We do pelvic exams for all kinds of reasons, but the bottom line is a Pap test screens for cervical cancer, and that should be done every few years for people in their 20s, and potentially every 5 years when people are over 30, depending on the results, of course.
Okay, thank you so much for this crucial information
sure.
here, and giving us instances where we need to still go in and make sure that everything is together, guys. We have a website down at the bottom of your screen if you have any more questions for Dr. Eisenberg or you want to go and visit them, and we will have this interview posted for you on our website. Fox2Now.com in just a few if you would like to see it again. Fox 2 News in the morning at 7 continues after this. Stay with us.